Hey guys, welcome back to WixFix. I hope you're having a fantastic day. In this video, I want to teach you my personal formula for designing mobile versions of your sites. If you weren't aware, about 50% of your users that come to your site will be on some sort of mobile device. So obviously, it is important to make sure that your site looks professional on both desktop and mobile. Now, some of you may have already seen me go through this process before in previous tutorials. However, as I plan to make more web design videos in the future, I do want to make this video so that I won't be repeating myself for every web design tutorial that I make. Basically, I just want to save both of us some time. And before we get started, I do want to mention that only 15% of my viewers are actually subscribed. So if you're new around here or you've been viewing my videos for a while, I want to challenge you to subscribe to the channel if you find this video useful at any point. Subscribing helps the channel grow. It also tells YouTube's algorithm that people are enjoying the content and they should promote the videos more. That way, more people get the help that they need. But with that out of the way, let's dive right into the video. So this is the site that we'll be working with today. I actually made this site as a skeleton for another client, but they chose to go with a different skeleton. And I didn't want this design to go to waste, because personally, I really love it. So I figured this would be a really good option for this video. But let's go ahead and switch over to the mobile editor, and we're gonna see what it looks like currently. It looks like a complete mess. So if you publish your site and completely forget about mobile, then you're basically guaranteed to lose half of your sales or half of your leads or whatever you're trying to get. You can just cut that in half because of the mobile version of your site. So in this video, I'm going to teach you what I do to make sure that the mobile versions of your site look really professional, just like your desktop. The first thing we're going to start with is the header. So if we hover over the header and we click it, we're going to see that the recommended header size is all the way up here, but our header is all the way down here. And you might be asking yourself, why is that? If we switch back over to desktop and we click on the header, we're going to notice that this is a strip split into two columns. So on mobile, if we click on the strip, we're going to notice that these two columns are taking up the entire header. And then this little mobile menu icon that automatically appears on mobile sites is also taking up some space as well. So what we want to do is confine all of our content up into the header, which if you think about headers that are on other popular websites, the only thing that you typically see is the logo and this little mobile menu icon. But here's a little side note. Obviously, we probably don't need these pages menus because that's going to be shown in this menu icon when the user presses it. But let's say it is important to us to have this start button available, but maybe we don't have the space in the header for it. So what we can do is right click on it. We can say move to menu box. Now it's going to open up our menu box and it's going to put our button inside of there. Now here is where our pages would be. Now if we add more pages to this, it would look nice, but right now I only have the home. But here we can also edit the design, colors, the fonts, everything like that. Which for this site, I am using Poppins. So I'm going to go ahead and choose Poppins Light, and I'm going to go ahead and make this 16 pixels. And if you want to, you can come over to selected and change the text color as well to match whatever branding you have. But if we look over here on desktop, it's pretty similar to what we currently have, so I'm not gonna really stress about it too much. And then if you want to edit your menu more, you can come click this little mobile menu icon and press edit menu. And now we can edit the menu to be whatever we want. And for this little X button, I'm gonna go ahead and move this to the right and move it to the top. Then what I'm gonna do is go ahead and press the shift key and down arrow once and left arrow once, just like that. And before I finish up the menu, if you want to, you can also change the background of this menu to a color or another image. For this example, I'm just gonna leave it as is. And then to close your menu, we're just gonna click this little X mobile menu icon and press close menu. So now all we have in the header is this column with these old menu icons, which we don't need, and this top column with the logo. So since we don't need this bottom column, I'm just going to select it and press hide element. The next thing I want to do is adjust the logo size so it's not as big. So I'm going to go ahead and adjust the little vector icon I have, and I'm going to lower the font as well, and I'm going to make sure it is aligned with the mobile menu. I'm going to select both, move it all the way to the left. I'm going to use the shift and right arrow key to move it over 2 times. Basically, all that did was move this logo 20 pixels away from the edge. It is best practice to make sure that everything is 20 pixels away from each edge, because if things are pressed up against it, then they may be cut off on some mobile devices. So obviously it is important just to make sure everything is set to the center. So now we can go ahead and adjust the strip height so it's kind of smaller, and then we can click the header element and move it up to the recommended size, just like that. Okay, the next thing I want to do is go ahead and grab this header, and I'm going to go ahead and make sure that it's in the front, because what I want to do for this example is something similar to the desktop, where the blue background is covering the header. So we're going to kind of replicate that on mobile. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is set this width to be 320 pixels. We're going to align it to the center, and we're going to put it at the top of this column. And next, we're going to go ahead and just drag it up. Great. Now it is behind our logo. But if we look at the mobile menu icon, it is black and it doesn't really show that well here on the mobile version of the site. So we're going to go ahead and click it. We're going to do edit design, customize design, fill opacity and color. And we're going to choose icon color to white. Alrighty, now we are already done with our header. So if we look at this column right here, there's nothing even in it. So we don't need this column taking up real estate on our mobile website. So we're just going to click that column and press hide. Okay, the next thing I want to do is somewhat replicate the style on desktop, where this image is kind of going over, you know, the blue and the white. So if we switch back over to mobile, what I'm going to do is just drag the strip up right about here. So now the image is kind of hanging over, similar to the desktop version of the site. And honestly, I feel like this section is basically complete, except for this little plus icon. You can find a place to put this, like you can put this on the edge of the image or something like that. You can hide it if you want, if you can't find a place for it. I'm just going to leave it there for now, and then I'm going to go ahead and shrink up this section a little bit, just like that. Now, if we click this text, we're going to notice that the font size is 23 pixels. Now, typically what I like to do is keep the titles and like headers to maybe like 20 to 16 pixels, and then paragraphs to 13 pixels. However, since this is going to be the main header on the website, I think the font size of 23 pixels here actually really works, so I'm actually going to leave this one as is. But for the rest of the titles and headers, I'm going to make them about 20 to 16 pixels. And for paragraphs, obviously, we're going to make them 13 pixels. Now, I do want to mention, depending on the font that you choose, you might have to adjust your sizing a little different, because the font size of 23 pixels for Poppins Medium looks really good. But if you're using like Roboto or something, 23 pixels may be a lot bigger and it might be a lot smaller. So with mobile, sometimes it is a little bit of guess and check until you really understand how it works. When I first started creating websites and Wix, everything looked really big on mobile. And that's because, you know, we are editing and creating a mobile website on a desktop computer. So it doesn't look too big or too small in our eyes when we're like staring at the Wix editor. However, if we pull it up on our phones, it could look completely different. So until you really understand like this formula, it might be beneficial just to publish the site when you think you're done, pull it up on your phone to check it, and then make adjustments as needed. Okay, so now that we have this section complete, we're gonna go ahead and move on to this section right here. So if we look right here, we're going to notice that there is this empty section right here. There's not a strip here to hide. There's not a column or anything. So we have this option right here to delete space. So basically what that's going to do is bring everything below it up. So we're going to go ahead and press it, and it's going to bring everything up. Now, I do want to bring this one down a little bit because this section is so small. I'm actually wanting to make this one about 150 pixels tall. Now I'm going to go ahead and center the text. Now, like I mentioned before, we want to make sure that these like paragraph text are about 13 pixels. And then these other ones, we're going to make this one like 18 pixels like that. Okay, and then we'll go ahead and press delete space underneath that. Okay, the next section that we have are these two little like portfolio showcase type things. Okay, so what I want to do for this section is I want to move this number over the image a little bit. So in order to do that, we actually need to ungroup it. So I'm going to select the group and ungroup. The next thing I want to do is pull out this little decorative little vector art thing. I'm going to make it a little bit bigger, probably about 40 pixels. I'm going to make the color white, and I'm going to put this inside that little box right there. And you can see it went behind. So what I'm going to do is come over to the arrange panel and bring that to the front. Okay, next what I'm going to do is go ahead and grab both, and I'm going to put them right here with the image. And now I'm going to click the image and drag it up. So it's going to look like that. The next thing I want to do is edit this text. So to keep everything consistent across your entire site, spacing wise, what I'm going to go ahead and do is just drag this up against the image. Then I'm going to use the shift and arrow key and go down 3 times. And then I'm going to do the same thing for this paragraph text. I'm going to move it down 2 times. So for this text, we're going to make sure it's 18 pixels. And then for this paragraph text, we're going to make sure it's 13 pixels. And then we're going to select the column and we're going to drag it down a little bit to give it a little bit more space before we hit this next section. And then what we're going to do is basically the same exact thing that we did up here. Okay, great. This website is already starting to come together quite nicely. The next section we have is this one right here. Now here we have this vertical text that looked really cool on desktop. However, to be honest, I really don't think it is needed in this particular instance. So what we're gonna do is just go ahead and hide it. And to be honest, you really can't be afraid to remove stuff from your mobile site. When your users come to your site, it is important for them to get a gist of what you are, but having them scroll down too much is going to be kind of like a turn off for them. So you don't want them to keep scrolling because they'll get something called scrolling fatigue. So you kind of just want to give them a gist of what you are or like what you're offering to them. And you can't really be afraid to just hide some stuff that are kind of unnecessary for mobile devices. So I'm going to keep this blue thing, but I'm going to make this one pretty small, like maybe like 20 pixels. And then for this image, we're going to make this one about 200 pixels. So this blue kind of gives it kind of like an accent a little bit. And maybe it might be good to make this one like 10 pixels, something like that. That looks pretty good. Now, if you notice, this image is taking up the full width of the screen. So if we come back to the desktop and we look at these images, these are image elements that are placed inside of a column. However, this image is the column background. So there's not really a way to, you know, make this one a floating one within the column. If you really want to add an image that looks like it's floating similar to this one, what you could do is select this column, hide it, and then you can come over to the add panel and add the image manually. Then you can get this style of a floating image like that. However, I do typically like to mix it up between floating images and column background images like this, so I'm just going to leave it as is. And if we look at this section, we're going to notice that there is this line here. And to be honest, it looks good on desktop, but it doesn't really look good on mobile, so I'm just going to go ahead and hide it. Next, I'm going to go ahead and ungroup this text right here. And I'm going to follow the same technique that I followed up here, where I'm going to put this one all the way up to the top. Move it down 30 pixels, put this text underneath that, move it down 20 pixels, and then another 20 pixels for the paragraph. And of course, we want to make sure these are all 18 pixels. Maybe this one can be 16 pixels, and then this one can be 13 pixels, just like that. And of course, we want to make sure that we give a little space below it. And this section looks really nice. Now we can notice that there is a lot of space right here between this and the next section. So we're going to go ahead and delete the space just to bring everything up for us. This section is going to be this section on desktop. So if we look right here, if I preview, we're going to notice that there is this little accent blue box, this little title, and this button. So I kind of want to replicate this on desktop or on mobile the best I can. So I'm going to go ahead and shrink this down quite a bit. Then I'm going to come over to the align and align to the right. Then I'm going to bring this up right here. I think that looks good. And I'm going to bring this button right underneath the text. And I'm going to move it down like 20 pixels, just like that. Now here is a prime example of something that will look really good in the editor, but when you publish the site, it'll look huge. If we look at this button, viewing it on a desktop computer, it looks okay. But if we publish this website and we pull it up on our phones, this button is going to look huge. So what I have found is that 100 pixels wide and 35 pixels in height is typically the best. Now, if you have more text in here, you can obviously adjust it to be maybe like 110 or 120 or whatever you need it to be, to where like the text looks like it has enough space on the right and left. So this is one of those things that's like, it's at your discretion, basically. So whatever size you want it to be, just make sure that it looks good after you publish it. So after you publish it, check it and make adjustments if needed, basically. Okay, we're just gonna bring this up to be about right here. We typically want to keep a similar spacing between here and here, and I think that looks good. Or sometimes you wanna keep it the same amount of space between the bottom of your content and the top of your content. So it would be something like that. And now that we've taken the button out of the second column, we don't need the second column anymore, so we're just gonna hide it. And below that is another section that arguably can be removed if you want it to. It's already pretty similar to the section up here, so if we want to, we could honestly just remove this section completely. Same with this one. And we can just go ahead and start on the footer. Okay, so if we look at the desktop, and we look at the footer, here it has like the contact information, has links to their social media, and then the logo. And then over here we have the contact form. And if we switch back over to mobile, we're gonna see that Wix basically try to put it in the similar position. However, with mobile, we typically wanna keep it the logo at the top, which if you wanna do centered here, you can. I'm just going to leave it to the left like I have been for the rest of the site to keep it consistent. Then I'm gonna shrink the logo down quite a bit. And now I'm gonna start putting the content underneath it, which for the footer content, I typically always try to keep stuff even smaller than normal. So I'm just going to make almost everything 13 pixels. And I'm gonna bring it up and just add 10 pixels of spacing in between both. For Facebook and Instagram, we're gonna shrink down the boxes and we're just gonna line them up like this. And we're just gonna bring them underneath and select both and give them 10 pixels of spacing. Then we're gonna bring this section up just like that. And now is the contact form. Now if we select the form, we're gonna notice that the width is set to 300 pixels and everything else that we've been having on our website is set to 280 pixels. 280 pixels basically means that there is 20 pixels on the right and 20 pixels on the left, which is exactly what we want. Because if you remember what I said up here when we were talking about the logo, if things are pressed up too far up against the left or the right, then on some devices things can get cut off. So while we've been designing this site, we've been making sure that, you know, all of the text are set to 280, these floating images are set to 280, so we obviously need to make sure that the form is as well. But if we select the main form element, we're going to see it's set to 300. But if we select the content inside of that form element, we're going to notice that it's set to 280. So honestly, that is okay. And honestly, all we really have to do now is kind of just adjust the font sizes for everything. So these are all set to 14, so we're just going to set everything to 13. And if you wanted to, you could honestly shrink down these a little bit more to be like 40 pixels, but honestly I feel like it's fine, so we're just gonna leave it as is. This is gonna be the mobile version of our website. And it looks pretty clean. But that basically wraps it up for the video today. If you guys did learn something or find this cool, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel for more Wix content coming out really soon. Thank you guys again, and I'll see y'all in the next one.